Thank you. I think by now you've gathered I'm not just a customer. However, just like you, I'm a service provider. When I commanded that mission, the STS-90 mission back in 1998, I took the perspective as the commander of this venture, this 8-year in preparation venture, that the people we are doing this mission for, the scientists who had devoted a big chunk of their careers and lives in preparing the experiments, the public who invested their confidence and money and effort in us in the human space program, they were all our customers. We needed to provide service to them. So in that sense, I'm exactly like you. Now, I come from a very technical background. I observed that many of you did not as I walked around. That's okay. That was not the purpose of this exercise today. In fact, I helped by interviewing some of the kids, and wow, that was so exciting. And one of them said something profound. I said, what was the most fun thing you were doing today? Thinking, you know, I'm a technical guy, rockets and stuff. She said, oh, it's all the people I got to work with. Isn't that what it's about? You know, today, over the next 30 minutes or so, I want to share with you my experiences in a very different career field, flying into space, what I've done. But keep in mind that we have so much in common. It's about providing service to others. And we're going to start with a couple stories, a couple nature stories, actually, metaphors, if you will. Let's start with, I'll take a poll here. You've got two images on the screen. You've got an eagle, lone eagle, flying high. It looks magnificent, doesn't it? Our national symbols, magnificent bird. You've also got a penguin rookery, very crowded, chaotic, looks a little confused in there, perhaps even a little smelly, you know, in that kind of environment. Which one of those two images best portrays the real world workplace? Yeah. Oh, of course we all get it. The penguin rookery, absolutely. And what happens is that one penguin leader leaves the rookery and goes down by the edge of the ice. Others start to follow, and then that brave penguin leader dives into the water, facing all those threats there, the sharks, the seals, the budget cuts, all of the things, all of the threats that we face, but does it anyway. And what happens? You've all seen March of the Penguins. They all follow, right? Exactly. We don't have to be the lone eagle to be a leader. We don't have to have the charisma of a John F. Kennedy. We can be that brave little penguin leader who recognizes that, well, you know what? I know what the right thing to do here is. I'm going to set an example. I'm going to influence for good, and I'm going to have the courage to try. And as we head out and do that, people will follow. They recognize that. It's been my privilege on three separate occasions to break those bonds of gravity, to go fly on his technology, to fly into space, and partake of what has been called the greatest human adventure. But also, it's a great venture, one that requires teamwork, leadership, innovation, peak performance at the very limits of human capabilities to really be successful.
But the keys to success in that venture are the exact same things, really, when you get down to it, when you boil it down to the essence, that you will need.
Rick Searfoss, 9 years in the United States Astronaut Corps, 40 days in orbit, 3 NASA shuttle missions, crew member and mission commander, sharing his experiences and skills with audiences all over the country. His topics range from effective team building to adaptability and peak performance. He has contributed to National Geographic magazine, the Discovery Channel, the BBC, and Dr. Stephen R. Covey's book, The Nature of Leadership.
The component which I believe absolutely firmly is the single most important thing for a leader to have, and that is trustworthiness. The ability to not only have incredible competence and that people can recognize you're a real expert in your field, but also that they will trust you and recognize your integrity is foremost and there in front of everything else. Obviously, we have to have that as we developed the skills and the ability to trust each other going to space, but it's crucial and absolutely the single most important thing in your dealings with other people. And every role that you take on, you should consider yourself in a leadership role. You lead your customers, you teach them, you develop solutions to their problems. Definitely leadership roles, and absolutely the most important thing you can bring to them is the worthiness of their trust. But there was one individual, Deke Slayton. How many of you have heard of Deke Slayton? Probably everyone, and one of the original 7 astronauts. So Deke Slayton's there at this reunion with his wife, and he made it a point to go around and personally meet all of the rookies. And he came up to my wife and I and said, well, welcome aboard. We're really glad you're here. Where'd you come from? I told him, Edwards. Oh, it was great. I had a great time there when I was a young test pilot. And like, we're so glad you're here. And you guys are going to contribute so much. We have so much going on. And it was phenomenal. It's that beyond respect, It's that considering the seeds of greatness are with anyone and taking it to the next level of reaching out and pulling them in. Great lesson to me and something I will always treasure. Now, as far as execution on a daily basis goes, I come from a very, very dynamic business. You know, flying fighter aircraft, test flying projects in the astronaut business, things happen in a real hurry. In fact, we have a saying in that business, nothing is so bad that you can't make it worse. And that is very, very true. Think about it for a second. In order to not make things worse and frame it in a more positive light, to move forward in a positive way on daily execution, you have to apply correct principles. Preparation is fundamental. This no stone unturned preparation, this willingness to do your homework. You know what? I think to be successful in sales, that's the exact same kind of preparation you need to go through. I think, and again, I would commend the company and this group because that's what you've been doing for the last several days. And those of you in particular who aced those exams through, that's indicative of that level of preparation, of knowing all of the technical details and specs and every question that your customer might throw at you regarding your products, having an answer for them. Now, Greg mentioned in the introduction that I was the chief judge for the Ansari X Prize. How many people have heard of that? Quite a few, a tech-oriented group. That's what I expected. For those of you that haven't, a couple years ago, you may have seen on the news, there was this little rocket ship that went to the edge of space, did it twice within 2 weeks, and it did it totally on private funds. That was the X Prize. That's what won that competition. I was out there on the desert in California, the Mojave Desert, when this happened. A phenomenal electricity in the air as people saw history being made. And I've reflected an awful lot after that. You know, how did this come to be? They were applying the correct principles of setting the bar high and having an amazing passion for their work, of something that was very important. I saw it come to pass. It is a great model and an example for what truly can happen when you pull the correct principles together with respect to purpose.